today, what I want to provide is an overview of what we are doing at BSC related with RISC-V, how we are contributing in some aspects, in some layers of the stack, RISC-V, and how also RISC-V is impacting on BSC. And for us, it's very important because, well, all of you here know that RISC-V is important for Europe. But all this strategy for us is based on three main concepts that are very important as a research center. So it's research, of course, it's education, and it's innovation. Yes, for all of you that doesn't know anything about BSC, Barcelona Supercomputing Center, or don't know many things, one of the main objectives of BSC is to provide supercomputing resources or services for the research community in Europe and also in Spain. And, well, we have supercomputer, now we have Mare Nostrum 5, this was the previous one, Mare Nostrum 4. Of course, if you want more information after this talk, we have a booth here in the exhibition area, so you are welcome to come and discuss anything you want. All the activities that I'm going to mention here are more related or are led by the computer science department at BSC. I mean, this is just a picture of what we are doing and what we have. There are more things, but just to give you an idea. It's very important to keep in mind that BSC is a research center, it's a public institution, okay? We are not a company, so we are not focused on products. What we want is to bring crazy ideas on the table and demonstrate that it makes sense. And as a research institution, of course, one of our pillars is getting projects funded, so we apply to calls to put these ideas, these crazy ideas, there and having an opportunity. And for this, we have mechanism. We apply to different calls at different. We target different funding entities. We have European layers here. We are very well, as a research center focused on HPC. Of course, Euro HPC for us is important. We also have, at national level, we have the Spanish government calls, and then also at regional level, we have the Catalonian government, where we apply for different projects. And this gives us the opportunity to have funding for also move to the other concept, which is education. With this money, we can do research, of course, but we also can bring talent and retain talent at BSC to do these things, and learning and teach them on the way. And also, we have the capabilities of contributing to the ecosystem. So here, again, we contribute at different levels. At European level, we participate on the competence centers in Europe and also on the Center of Excellence, very focused on HPC, of course. But then when we move to national level, we are participating and coordinating the Spanish Open Hardware Alliance, and this is very focused on RISC-V. So here, the idea is to strengthen the capabilities and the skills on microelectronics and semiconductor, and here RISC-V, of course, plays a very important role also in Spain, not only in Europe, but particularly locally in Spain. But also, we are working at in-house, the BSC. We are preparing courses and trainings based on RISC-V on the different layers of the software stack and hardware stack. So with this research here, we have funding, we have crazy ideas, we have people to run those projects and educate those. We can work on the third pillar, although all these concepts are related to each other, okay? We can be crazy and bring innovation. This is just an overview of the research part. Very focused on RISC-V at BSC. We are working on many projects. We are working, again, on the software and hardware stack, but all this talk is more focused on hardware because it's where we have, let's say, less experience, and we are speeding up from during these years. We start on RISC-V with the API project, working on a vector processing unit. And part of the result of that is you can sit in our booth, and Filippo is over there, so he can explain more things about that. But then we have been collaborating in more projects, and now we are running more than 10 projects related with RISC-V. And not only for traditional HPC domain, which is the objective is having the future supercomputers or participating in those, but also automotive, edge, space, So HPC is everywhere, and we have to be aware. So we consider HPC in a broader way. It's not just the traditional one. And it's important. And here is where we move to the innovation. So here, I want to start with the educational part. So we start being more involved in hardware with the EPI project. We have, as you see, as you saw, so we are running many projects now, participating in those. And we have to, to organize the way we work. We have to rethink the way we work to be more effective, more efficient, to provide more quality to the things that we do. And that's the reason why we reorganize also the people that is working at PSC in different, or being more specialized on this. So we have simulation, RTL, verification, FPGA for the emulation, and physical design as main pillars here. So we have projects more focused in each of the pieces, but at the end what we want is to be sure that if we go for a tape out, for example, we cover all the different stages. And on the way, we generate infrastructure to be sure that we can use and reuse and grow on top of those to add more features. As a consequence of this, I don't know what you see, we have developed our own IPs. We have cores, we have coprocessor, where the vector processing unit is our flagship. And we also are moving from single core to a multi-core. And for that, we are taking advantage also of the open source ecosystem that we have at RISC-V. So we started with very basic processor, in-order core, Lagarto Hoon. Then we have Sargantana, and then we move to out of order. All these things help us to get knowledge, know-how, and then apply it to move forward and prepare the future accelerators. If we combine these with our VPU, which is configurable, you can enable with 8 or 16 lanes, and it's compatible with the RISC-V vector extension 1.0, we have just, you know, more capabilities enabled there. But then if we move to a multi-core system, then we can, you know, start thinking on HPC. If you want more information or you want to take a look through some of the IPs that we have open source, this is the repo. You have to take a look. And let's see what we have done here. So we have been working, as I said, from something simple, let's say, single core, standalone, to a multi-core system. And we have used OpenPython as a vehicle to do that. It's an open source project, but it's not HPC friendly. So what we have done there is to enable, adapt the project to add new features. Some of those are being on the cache, on the memory hierarchy. Now we have a three-level cache hierarchy where the L1 and L2 are private, the L3 is shared among all the cores. In the L1, we have modified the cache and we have integrated the high-performance data cache from CEA and make all the system compatible with our cores and our coprocessors. We have also added the possibility of having access to multiple memory controllers, and we also have integrated our Pronoc router here. At least it's compatible, so you can enable, you can use by default the OpenPython one, or you can use this with add new features to the routing characteristics. But then when we move to the emulation, as remember, so once we verify something, we want to see if the RTL behaves properly before going for a tape out or before going to silicon. So we have large-scale FPGA infrastructure, which is the outcome of one of the projects where we participated, and the MIMP project. And it has 12 nodes, each node with 8 FPGAs, and we use it as an RTL or hardware emulator. So here what we have done is to also adapt OpenPython to be compatible with the FPGAs that we have. So it's a mechanism to test things, but also we have developed different tools to make this possible. I mean, to add some capabilities, observabilities, and making the life of our designers easier in terms of communication, because FPGAs are not, you know, easy to use, let's say. So one of the tools we are developing on the observability is a tracer. The idea here is to do some verification on the FPGAs and just to make things easier for the verification team. It's not easy. And what else? And also the partition. You know, if we want to scale a design, sometimes it doesn't fit on one FPGA. So how can we do this? What we want to do is logically having a big design, but we want to partition that design and split different bit streams on different FPGAs connected to each other. Okay, so we are working on this and using, of course, OpenPython as a proof of concept for this. And this has more implications, but whatever, this is one of the goals. And this is our experience on chips. Again, based on BSC IPs, our experience. We started in 2019 with the very basic in-order core, Lagarto-Hun, and now we have been moving to a more complex designs with different accelerators, and now the objective is to move to a multi-core system where we want to combine our more advanced cores where we will enable one or the other, but at least we have a baseline to test things and to run different scenarios. What else? Well, this is the way we work. We have listened in many talks here that, okay, hardware doesn't make sense if we don't have software. Software doesn't make sense. I mean, that doesn't make sense. We don't want to evolve the software if we don't have hardware. So when something that we are doing here at BSC, and we have been doing for many times, but now we want to include RISC-V and the hardware layers here, is working on a hardware-software co-design manner. And we have two approaches here. We have a top-down approach and also a bottom-up approach. What does this mean? We have use cases because as a research center, we have different departments with applications that they are running every day, complex models. So perfect, we have use cases, so let's use it. We have supercomputer resources. Great, let's use those and learn on the way. What are the hotspots of those applications? How can we outperform the execution of those ones? We had Mare Nostrum 4. Now we can learn from those experiences. Now let's replicate the same on Mare Nostrum 5. And once we run on the general purpose partition of Mare Nostrum 5, let's analyze things and how can we outperform that following the software stack. So layer by layer, we can do better and analyze the execution. If we identify that some parts are suitable to be accelerated on GPU, perfect. Let's use the GPU partition, the acceleration partition that we have in Mare Nostrum 5. But what else with all those parts that are not well suited for GPUs? Or yes, but we want to try a different way. Let's put RISC-V there, and let's see what happens. On the bottom up here, the idea is to learn and use also our technology as a baseline to test those applications, to run those applications. So we have two possibilities, let's say. One is one of the things that we are doing, the APIs that we already have, let's use those, execute things, and see how can we evolve those, perhaps with custom instructions or debugging or whatever. Use those to execute things and improve those. But we can think also out of the box. We can be more innovative, more creative. And that's the idea also of some of the lines that we want to apply to there, and also with our research at BSC is, okay, we have this problem, what we can do with this? Don't put barriers on the thing that we can do with RISC-V, okay? And as at the end, let's test this on an emulator and see if that makes sense. Having a proof of concept perhaps help us also to cover all the hardware and software stack and influence in the future supercomputers or HPC solutions. And I think with that, this provides an overview of all the things that we are doing. We are also working on a catalog of IPs, RISC-V IPs at BSC, so we have the first version on the booth. So welcome to come and to ask questions. Thank you. ¿Hay tiempo para?
We have time for one quick question.
Quick. Easy.
So.
No question. All clear. I'm great.
All clear. So how can we help you or use your machines or anything that you are providing to the community?
So one of the things that we listened on Monday, for example, was that there are not emulators for designers, RISC-V designers. One of the things that we want to do with this infrastructure based on FPGAs is to provide that service. We are not yet there, so we are opening the infrastructure for using our technology and run things on top of that. But one of the things that we want to do is to be certified as RISC-V lab. Let's see when, okay, little by little. And later open the infrastructure to also developers to test to emulate the hardware on this infrastructure. So that's one of the ways that we think we can contribute to the community to evolve and also receive feedback, of course.
So thank you so much.
Thank you.